Here are four ways in which porn fucked up my life, and I'm telling you these things so that you don't repeat the same mistakes I made. First of all, porn offers you instant gratification. You receive pleasure and satisfaction without having done any fucking thing to earn it. And with this, you develop a very unhealthy approach when it comes to intimate situations in your life. For every woman that comes and goes in your life, you will have some false expectations that you are to have sex with this woman without having done anything to deserve it. You haven't established a connection first. You haven't got to know this woman. You haven't even allowed yourself to go all in on this situation. You give her your cock, but you don't give her your emotions and your full physical presence. You remain protected and disconnected. Two, porn destroyed my confidence. Understand, when you watch a porn movie, you're watching high-level performers go at it. These men who are fucking jacked up and full to the brim with fucking Viagra pills and whatever else, and are instantly hard when it comes to getting their fucking clothes off with a woman. And this doesn't always happen in real-life situations. But if this is your internal belief based on what you've watched on a porn site and it doesn't happen for you in a real-life situation, well, that's going to fuck up the whole exchange. Because if you don't get instantly hard, you start fucking shitting yourself and thinking, what the fuck is wrong with me? I'm supposed to be hard right now because of what I've watched on a porn site. This is the way it's supposed to happen. My friend, it doesn't always happen this way. And I have been caught in that situation all too many times in my younger life. And this creates a huge level of anxiety when it comes to sexual exchanges with a woman. So much so that you will avoid a real life sexual, intimate, amazing encounter with a woman because you associate that with a potential anxious, painful experience and you avoid it. And in the avoidance of those real life intimate scenarios, you will begin to use porn even more for your intimacy. And that can become a real fucking problem. Three, porn was a soother for an underlying pain or trauma that I had not yet addressed. Porn was associated with a broken connection that I had in my younger life that I had never really understood the significance of until only about 5 or 6 years ago. This broken connection that I had spent my whole life trying to cultivate again, but could never find it, and therefore replaced that real life connection with a connection through fantasy, a connection through porn. These intimate situations where a woman would be naked on a screen, feeling like she was doing that for me, feeling like I was part of that scene, creating this fantasy in my mind that I was the man in the video fucking this woman. And this giving me an incredible feeling of love and connection. But none of that was fucking real. And all that did was exasperate the pain that I had within, because by not sitting with the pain, by not healing the pain took a tighter grip on my life. And as it tightened its grip, I used porn all the more to run away from it, until eventually I couldn't take it anymore. The pain became too overwhelming and it completely fucking floored me. And it was only at that point that I began to make some changes to my life, that I began to reach out and speak to someone about the struggles I was having. And then understanding that the porn was never the problem. It was the pain beneath the porn. That was the problem. And that's what I needed to address in order to get beyond my porn addiction. Four, I began to pornify every attractive woman that I had seen in my life. Anytime I would be in a real life situation where a woman would be simply walking down the street, or I'd see an attractive woman in a shop or a store, I would immediately visualize myself having sex with her or seeing her naked, and therefore fail to understand that this woman is a fucking human being. This woman has got feelings and emotions, and this woman as well potentially wants to cultivate a true, real life connection with a man in her life. And I was destroying this opportunity for her, and I was destroying this opportunity for me. Because if it's only about sex, then you don't take time to really begin to value this woman as a person, to really admire her personality, to really fall in love with who she is, not only with her clothes off, but also with her clothes on. That even when it's all said and done, and you've had sex together and you've ejaculated, and that thrill is gone, that you still have this underlying gratitude to be able to just lie there in bed with this woman and feel a deep sense of connection with somebody without having to penetrate her on a physical level, because you've penetrated her on an emotional level, and she too has allowed you to do that. She too has lowered her defenses and allowed you to come into her life because she trusts you, because she knows that you're not just in it for the sex. So if all you're ever doing is pornifying women and chasing them for sexual exploits, chasing them for your own pleasures and your own thrills, well, guess what, man? You are killing off any fucking opportunity for something greater in your life. A true, real life connection beats the fuck out of short-term, intimate connection. So don't jeopardize these opportunities for yourself in your life by continuing to indulge in some fantasy bullshit on a screen. Turn that fucking thing off. Lift your fucking head up. Get outside. Go and talk to women. Make opportunities happen instead of squandering them by hiding in your fucking room and having your defenses up because you're afraid to let anybody in because you could potentially be hurt or rejected. Learn to accept yourself first and then move on with your life with the confidence and the resilience to know that even if you are rejected, you are still a man of value and integrity. Get after it, my friend.